all we have to do, I have our tart shell here sprayed nicely with oil, and you're just gonna press your dough into the tart shell. And you want it nice and even, not too thin, or your tart shell will break. And you start it at the bottom and work your way up around the edges and make sure that you have a nice, even, sharp corner as you're doing it. And what we're gonna do once this is finished, we're going to blind bake it, which means that we pre-bake it, since the filling is a cold filling. We pre-bake it with some baking beans and cook it all the way through. So I'll show you that process next. So I have my parchment paper under it, and this is what blind baking is. It's the parchment paper with the baking beans. And what I did is I poked holes in it, I docked it with my docking device here, really cool device. And we're going to bake this at 400 degrees for 15 minutes, and then take the beans off and bake it for an additional 5 minutes at 350 degrees. So I'm gonna pop this in the oven now. All right, so we are going to make our peanut butter and milk chocolate ganache next. This is gonna go into our tart shell filling. So I have my heavy cream boiled, and what I'm going to do is pour it right on top of my milk chocolate and my peanut butter. And you just wanna let that sit for like a minute. And then just whisk it up. And this is gonna go right into our pre-baked tart shells that we already baked. So we just wanna whisk this until it's smooth, and then we're gonna put it into the fridge until it's fully set up, and then we're gonna glaze them. So this is what it looks like when it's ready. So I'm just gonna pour it right into our tart shells. And it smells so good. So this is ready to go. I'm gonna put it into the fridge and let it set up for a little bit, and then we're gonna come back and glaze them. All right, so now I'm going to make the milk chocolate glaze that will go on top of our super yummy tarts. So what I'm gonna do, I have our heavy cream, our water, and our light corn syrup in this pot. And we're gonna let it come to a boil, and then I'm going to add in my milk chocolate, stir it all up, and pour it on top of these tarts. While that's boiling, I can pop these out of the shell. Real nice. All right, so now that it's boiled, I'm going to pour in my chocolate and just stir that up until my chocolate is melted. All right, so this is what it should look like when it's ready to go. So what I'm gonna do, so you could get an even coat, is you take your tart and you pour this on and then slowly tilt it around so it's an even coating. So don't pour that much on, and just slowly move it around. Work it if you need a little bit more. All right, so I'm gonna pop this in the fridge for another 5 minutes until it sets up, and then we're gonna put all of our toppings on it. All right, so here we have our finished tart. So we're gonna put some garnishes on it to make it look all pretty and beautiful. So I have some ground up pretzels that I'm just gonna put around to give it some color. The finished product looks really nice with the pretzels. And then I have some raspberries that I just cut in half, because raspberries go really well with the peanut butter and milk chocolate. Excuse me. Put some upside down. You could do whatever you want. This is the fun part about decorating. So then I also have some chocolate curls. We'll just sprinkle those around. To leave this part of the tart untouched because it's very shiny and just smooth. And I have some pretzels here. I dipped some in chocolate, so I'm gonna put some of these on the tart as well. I have some big chocolate sticks. textures and shapes and height. And I have these really cool chocolate garnishes that I like to use in my desserts. So we could just put some, have some sticking up just to give it more color. And we could do a little bit more pretzel powder. And there you have the chocolate and peanut butter milk chocolate tart.